Challenger Deep is an extreme environment. It's the deepest ocean abyss we're aware of at this time.
I view the work we're doing at Challenger Deep similar to what astronomers and astrophysicists do in deep space, where they send a probe out to investigate the deepest regions of our solar system. We are putting a deep ocean probe into the far reaches of deep inner space, getting a new view of how our planet works. Hoping to accomplish two major things. First was to achieve the technical challenge of getting a hydrophone and mooring system to survive going to that deepest part of the ocean.
The challenge is make the system to withstand this pressure, enormous pressure, which is about 16,000 psi. The Challenger Deep hydrophone is by far the deepest hydrophone we have ever designed.
Secondly, we wanted to make the first sound recording ever made at Challenger Deep.
It's away from all the sound sources, including ships, waves, and whales. It should be quiet.
We weren't expecting to hear very much, and we were a little bit shocked because we did see a lot of other sounds. We saw ships, we saw marine mammals that were typically very near the surface. So the sound was getting down into the deepest parts of the canyon, propagating down in there. Our analysis packages transform the data into a visual display, and we call it a spectrogram. And basically what the spectrogram is a time frequency breakdown.
It makes it fairly easy to see what the different sources of sound are on the record. So when an earthquake goes by, they'll show up as a big yellow blip. Baleen whales are much higher frequency, can be anything from 50 to 100 hertz or higher. But when a typhoon rolled through, like we had at the end of the record, it made so much noise in the whole water column from the wind and the wave noise coming up the sea surface that that whole bandwidth of sound is all bright yellow. So that stands out. It's been known since the 1960s that sound is increasing in the ocean, and this is thought to be due to increasing global shipping because of increases in global commerce worldwide. What we don't know is how this increase in sound is affecting marine ecosystems and marine animals that use sound to navigate, orient, and find food.
That is the motivation why we are studying this trend of ocean noise. What we're collecting now would help us compare the data 10 years from now.
In the true vein of ocean exploration, it's allowing us to look at the Earth in a new way.